It's October, the hottest month of the year, and I'm heading to Badari, located 8 hours away by car in the hottest region of the Gambia. Why am I doing this? A good question, you ask. I'm heading to Badari because it is one of four sites in this year's HIV/AIDS Bike Trek, an initiative started by Peace Corps volunteers last year.
So basically we have four teams of roughly 10 Peace Corps volunteers going to four different schools, so Sugawala Basic Cycle, Badari Basic Cycle, Bakadaji Basic Cycle, and Bansam Upper Basic. So four schools in either the Eastern Central River region or the Upper River region, which are typically the most marginalized regions within the Gambia. We're teaching in Upper Basic schools, which is, think of middle schools in America, grades 7, 8, and 9. The first day's lesson plan is, what is HIV/AIDS, how they're different, how can somebody protect themselves from HIV, and how is HIV passed from one person to another. And then the second day is basically life skills on how to take the knowledge that you learned the first day and craft a statement that's based on opinions and values so that the kids can be effective sensitizers within their community about HIV.
Okay, so now you have the body fluids poster. Now you're gonna go back through the body fluids poster to explain transmission. So you're gonna say like, okay, now we're gonna talk about how HIV can move from one person to another. This is called transmission. And then you kind of pose it as questions, like how might someone's blood mix? And start with blood, because that's like the least awkward of the fluids. Because a lot of the times, like when they learn about HIV, they talk a lot about like sharing razors or sharing chewing sticks. Like that's the way that HIV can be transmitted. But the biggest problem is unprotected vaginal sex. So making sure that you really like hammer that point home, and that's what we want them to remember. This is probably the first time that an adult is going to speak honestly to students about, or it might be one of the first times that someone has spoken honestly to them about sex and spoken to them in a respectful way. So like we're treating them as adults, we're giving them information, and that I think also goes a long way. Like the students are, they do appreciate that we're going to give them this information.
An advantage could be if the facilitator build that environment for them to look. Let's pick up. We are all equal here. I'm not here to teach you, but I'm here to share knowledge with you, to share my experience with you, so that you know someday you will not be a victim. Mm-hmm. You feel very comfortable.
The prevalence of HIV is around 2%, but it's always rising. And also, HIV-2, which is the less virulent kind, the less dangerous kind, is actually dropping off in incidence. And HIV-1, the more virulent, more dangerous kind, is actually rising in prevalence. And so that is a concern for us. And that makes us think that 10, 15, 20 years from now, HIV prevalence in Gambia will be higher. Right now it's around 2% compared to as high as sometimes 30% in areas like Swaziland or other areas of Africa. So it kind of feels like maybe HIV is not an issue here, but it is. And the prevalence here is certainly higher than the Western world, and it's rising.
So we are the Peace Corps, and we have come here with the National AIDS Secretary under the Office of the President, and also with Nova Scotia Gambia. So we have here with us Young Kuba. Okay? So we have come here today and tomorrow just to talk to you about HIV, and we hope that we can all learn about HIV together. Okay?
Each classroom features rules to guide the students and teachers, as well as a clear set of goals for the class to reach.
Can we all agree to ask questions?
Yes.
Can we say, I will ask questions.
Ask questions.
We all just agree that we will ask questions.
Thank you all.
So confidentiality. Has anyone heard this word before? Has anyone heard it before? It's a big word. Has anyone heard of confidential? What does confidential mean? No one knows, huh? Okay, so when something is confidential, it's a secret. What's a secret mean? So in this way, this case, what confidentiality means is all of us in here are going to talk about a lot of things today and tomorrow. And sometimes we don't want to go out into the schoolyard and tell everybody else what everyone says. So we're going to keep it a secret. Okay.
Stigma for HIV and AIDS in Gambia is quite high. People have a high level of knowledge about HIV, but they're very nervous about knowing someone who has HIV. They're very scared about getting it themselves, and they believe that once you get HIV, it's a death sentence.
You know, someday you might need this information to stay healthy. Someday you might need this information to go and help your brothers, to go and help your mothers, to go and help the community at large.
We just want you to know that if you go to the doctor and your blood soldiers are low because you have HIV, the doctor can give you medicine to keep your blood soldiers from dying. Does that make sense?
The way that it protects you is by completely covering the penis. And so no fluids are exchanged from one person to another, okay? So we want to make sure that it is completely together and intact, okay? So Castle is going to hold this bottle, okay? So this will represent a penis, so we will pretend that this is a penis, okay? So now that we have checked the expiration date, we have discussed with our partner, we have made sure that the condom is not broken, now we will put it on, okay? So you hold the very tip of it, you see this? You see the tip? You hold this here. And then the condom rolls on the outside, okay? So holding the tip, we put it onto the penis, and we roll it all the way down. Okay? So now the condom is on, and there's a little tip at the end. This is called the reservoir. It's not important, but this is where the semen goes. So when the man is finished having sex, and the semen will come out of his penis, it goes into this reservoir at the top, and that's why it's important to pinch that when you put it on. Okay? So then the two people, they have sex, and now they are finished. Okay? So now the man will go away from... So he'll move away. So he moves away from the woman. Okay? So when he takes off the condom, the semen does not get out. Right?
Gambia is an extremely young country. About 43% of Gambia is either 14 or younger. And so it's important to understand how HIV AIDS, which is typically a sexually transmitted disease, which affects people that are having sex. It's important to empower young people with information and life skills that are on the cusp of their sexual debut to be able to speak out and sensitize their communities about HIV.
You should have seen the curse that flew right by you. Page of concrete, stainwashed crutch and hobbled slave.
A good number of children in Gambia's education system cannot understand English, the official language in schools. Illiteracy runs high as well. Despite these obstacles, the bike trek facilitators press on. They amend certain lessons and decide to let the teachers and children speak local language when possible to get the message across. Day 2 brings the life skills curriculum, as well as a song from Remy.
So you said education, safety and equality, karandiro, takandiro, aninyo, kanyandiro, will be, they are all, these are the keys
of fighting
to fighting HIV. Can we say it together?
These are the keys of fighting HIV.
Again?
These are the keys of fighting HIV.
Education, safety, and equality. These are the keys to
nation's safety and equality. These are the keys to fighting HIV. Safety is the second key. Please use protection properly. Abstinence, faithfulness, and honesty. These can keep us safe.
That the outcome for the spike trek is, we're hoping to reach around 1,000 kids. Not sure if we're going to make 1,000, but we want 1,000 kids spread out through these four communities that are already marginalized to be able to go home within their communities and teach their younger brothers and sisters and their peers that don't have the opportunity to go to school about HIV and AIDS. And we want to change the culture. There's a lot of stigma that goes on in this culture, and not a lot of people like to talk about sexual and reproductive health. And if we reach this many kids, there's a chance that they can actually change the culture. So that is really the main objective.
My name is Mauro Pablo. I don't know how to speak about HIV.
My name is Kevin.
My name is Anita. I know I can speak about HIV and AIDS.
My name is Adamo Bande. I know I can speak about HIV and egg.
My name is Seku Jalo. I know I can speak about HIV.
What's your name?
My name is Ablan Malo. I know I can speak about HIV.
My name is Mr. Sriwe. I know I can speak about HIV and AIDS.
My name is Mr. Ba. I think I can speak about HIV.
Hey, look, one more.
My name is Bubakar Danjo, and I know I can speak about HIV and AIDS, and all the time now, anyone has questions, I will answer them. In my village, in my family, with my friends, on the football field, at dinner, at school, I can speak about HIV and AIDS.
So we are going to say we are ready to speak up about HIV and AIDS. Is that clear?
Yes.
1, 2, 3.
We are ready to speak up about HIV and AIDS.
Again?
We are ready to speak up about HIV and AIDS.
Share your knowledge about HIV. Right?
Woo! Nice.